Not really. I have no remorse, no compassion, no regard for Resident Evil puzzles. And speaking of which, I'm about to solve another one. Tasty, tasty soda. And what's behind the magic door number one? A wooden crest. I think it's the wind crest. Yes, the wind crest. Okay. Now we go put that gold emblem where that other emblem was. We do the old switcheroo. You remember that? Yeah. We're doing it again. Oh, yeah. This time it's the explicit XXX Sephiroth edition. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, seriously. Don't try to make sense of the words that are coming out of my mouth, because it is an impossibility. Will you take the mansion key? Why, yes, I think I will. Also, there's ink ribbons. There's also handgun bullets. I mean, clip, sorry. Yes, sit down. Thank you. You are very kind, Mr. Zombie. By kind, I mean dead. You're much nicer when you don't move and try and attack me. This whole being emotionless thing is something I approve of. Keep at it, good sir. Hey. We got a crawler. I'll take one of these green herbs. Ah, yummy, yummy, yummy. I am drinking cherry coke. Yes, be jealous. Be so, so unbelievably jealous. I'm gonna go this way because I want to knock out that armor key door. I'm not gonna go in it, I just want to unlock it. Before I finish recording, I want to use this armor key on every door. Because if I don't have any armor doors to unlock, that will make getting around pretty easy. Alright. There's some herbs in there, but I'm gonna wait until the dogs have changed into zombies. And that's after the hunters start hanging out in this mansion. So, those are like herbs I'm gonna have on, you know, backup in case I fuck up. Which, as I said before, is a very distinct possibility. Okay. Are you dead? I'll take that as a no. Okay. That will make it easier on me to get around him. He can sometimes be a little tricky to dodge. He's not too bad to dodge, but sometimes I could be stupid and run right into him. Sorry, inventory management time. Okay. 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 Alrighty then. No, I want to go get that lighter. You don't really need it on the regular scenario, but it does help. You can get some, you know, ammo and stuff. It's not really required. You don't have to use it to get a key, like on advanced mode. When I first played on advanced mode, I was like, I couldn't figure out where the sword key was. I was perplexed by the absence of this key, because I checked everywhere at other spawn points, and eventually I was just like, well, let me just try and check here, and I eventually found it. And yeah, it took me so long to figure out when I was a little kid. But now it seems like child's play. You know, because it is, but yes. Clip, how I've missed you. Now, is it me, or does it look like there's, like, bodies, like, under these sheets? To me, it looks like, you know, this room kind of creeps me out a little bit. It's, I don't know, it always has. I know it's just a bedroom, and there's no enemies in here, but still. And usually I think there's a zombie that in here, but not this time, that's kind of weird. Huh. Barry's not in here? I was hoping he would be. Researchers will. My dear Alma. Blah, 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 blah. Pause if you want to read it. Blah, 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 blah. Colleagues who are infected by the virus are dead. Living dead. Takes away all the humanity from the human brain. Yes, I'm infected. If you want to read that, yeah. Basically, researcher was like, hey, we've been studying this virus and it escaped and my coworkers are already zombies and I'm going to become one too. So, to prevent that, I'm going to kill myself. That's pretty much what the letter said. Kind of depressing, if you find such things depressing. Maybe not. Maybe you find being infected and turning into a zombie and then choosing to end your life to avoid said zombification to be something of a very cheerful and wondrous occasion. To which I say, what? Oh yeah, I want to show you something. My older brother used to play, you know, this game a lot. He used to say this lab coat looked like a giant condom. Just, look at that and think about that for a little bit. don't even ask. Okay. We're doing it, folks. We're doing it. What are we doing? We're all picking up this green herb, apparently. But... oh, damn it. I keep fucking it up. The combined is on the bottom. When will I ever learn that? Probably not any time during this, LP. Oh, that is bullshit. I'm standing right in front of it. Okay, it's a map of the second floor. Will you take it? You've got the map of second floor. Alright, I think I got just two more armor doors I gotta knock out here. First this one. I'm not going in it just yet, because I'm gonna end my recording soon. Yes. This key is useless now, discard. Okay, if that's how you feel. You're like, yeah, you helped me open his door. Fuck you, key. Throw you somewhere. Yes, push that statue, baby. Okay. Now I push the big shiny red button. Beedoop. Yeah. Yeah, all right. Yeah, okay. Don't push the statue. Poisonous gas will suddenly surface, and I'll be like, and then I'll be dead. Yay. So much awesome is happening. Alright, gonna save my game, and then, yeah, it's still snowing like crazy outside, it's, you know, I heard they're gonna say it might snow some, but holy crap, this is ridiculous. The wind is so intense that it's literally snowing sideways, and it's been doing that for like the past 4 hours. I mean, it's kind of awesome. But it's kind of really going to suck if I have to drive in that. Because I hate driving in inclement weather. But I'm pretty sure that goes for everybody. I mean, who enjoys driving? Yeah! It's snowing out! Let's put my life at risk. I'm going to be as stupid. Okay. Enough about that. I can save my progress with this. Will I use an ink ribbon? Well, too many files. Bullshit. Okay. I'm gonna go over this one. Since save file 3 was from my, Chris scenario, and I want to show something off as a bonus video when I finish Jill scenario. But anyways, this is Let's Play Resident Evil Director's Cut with Jill Valentine. The next part, we'll start finishing up some of the mansion puzzles and encounter Mr. Snakey Snake. Alright, peace out. Peace.